What's up guys, Sportshot here, and today I'm going to be showing you guys everything that you need to know about using helicopters for close air support in War Thunder. I'm also going to be showing you guys how to research helicopters at your maximum efficiency, basically how to research them very fast compared to usual methods. Anyway, let's just get right into it. But before we do, you guys should subscribe and hit that bell notification button so you do get notified of more videos like this, and I will be putting out a part 2 to this video for fixed wing aircraft like jets. In the future, probably in about a week, so if you guys want to see that, remember to subscribe and hit that bell notification button so you're notified. Anyway, let's just get right into it. So first I'm going to be showing you guys how to actually get your first helicopter and how to actually research helicopters very quickly. So how to get your first helicopter, all you need to do is get a tank or aircraft of the 5th rank, and that means any tank right here, you just have to get one of them, or any aircraft right on the 5th rank as well, you just need to get one. And then you can just straight up buy your first helicopter. You don't even have to research it. So yeah, you get the H1G for America, and you can just check whichever helicopter you want. I just noticed I can get the German one for some reason. Didn't know that, but now I do. Anyway, yeah, it is pretty easy to get your first helicopter, especially if you have been playing the game for a few months. But if you want to get your second helicopter or more research done for your current helicopter, all you have to do is make sure that you have a booster. I'm not going to turn on mine right now because I don't want to get into a match, because these matches are very long and that is why they are good. If you put on a booster, especially if you can get like a 500% RP booster, you can have a 500% RP booster for a few hours if you go into the simulator battle. What these simulator battles do with helicopters is they're basically just helicopter arcade mode, and you shoot down AI enemies, so you can rack up a very large amount of kills in whatever battle you do get into. And you get to use your booster the entire time. These battles can be anywhere from 45 minutes to around 2.5 hours. And you can leave at any time and there won't be any punishment for leaving. So I really do suggest, if you do have a booster and an hour or two to spare, go into one of these helicopter battles, and you could research an entire helicopter just in one day. So yeah, it is very useful. Anyway, let's just get right into the next part of it. So now that you do have your helicopter, you're gonna want to be able to actually use it. So with most helicopters, you will not get any ATGMs. I actually think this might be for all helicopters, except for premiums. You won't get any ATGMs at all. No guided munitions right when you get it, so you're gonna have to be able to use your kind of unguided munitions. So you're gonna have guns, grenade launchers, and rockets. So when you do only have unguided munitions, there is no perfect way to go about it. You do have two options though that work fairly well. When you do know that there is radar guided SPAA or any kind of any aircraft that can lock onto you, basically what you want to do is stick to the ground. But if not, you want to go as high as possible, so normal tanks can't really hit you that well. And when you are high and there are no SPAs that can hit you, then you will have an option where to fight, and you can pick and choose your fights. How do you know whether or not there are SPAs? Basically what you do is you just kind of look at who is on your team, and if your teammates are at a BR to kind of allow radar guided SPAs, then there are probably radar guided SPAs, but they usually do not spawn in first thing in the battle. So if you are spawning in your helicopter first thing in the battle and not as your second life or your third life, then you generally are okay to just go up straight up into the air and get as much altitude as you can, so you can just drop on somebody whenever you want. So I'm just gonna look around for a target down here, something for me to shoot at. Now, you generally don't want to go up against multiple tanks at once, because if you do get a kill on one, the other one's going to have you dead with their machine gun. So I see a massive, I think it's an FV4005. I'm just going to drop on it, and what you want to do is you want to do one run. You want to drop on it and get out. Why am I turning? Why? I have no idea what just happened there. But you should get the idea. I don't know why I pitched that way. I have no clue. I'm gonna look at the replay to see what happened, but you get the idea. What you wanna do is you wanna go up really high, drop on somebody, and get out. Get out as soon as you can, because when people notice that there's a helicopter, on their level, really close to them, they're going to turn to it and start shooting at it with their machine guns. And helicopters are very lightly armored, unless you're looking at like a Mi-24. On the Russians, or some of the higher tier helicopters do have some armor, but for the most part, helicopters have no armor and can get completely destroyed by machine gun fire. So make sure that when you do drop, you get out as soon as possible. Only stay around for one kill and don't try to hover around unless you know that the people that you're shooting at aren't looking at you. But that's going to be very rare. So now I'll be showing you guys how to use ATGMs on your helicopters. First thing that you're going to want to do is you're going to want to look at your ATGMs and find the firing range. My firing range is about 4 kilometers, so I'm going to want to get slightly less than 4 kilometers, about 3.5 kilometers to 3 kilometers away from the map. Now this hill looks like it will be nice cover. You want to start looking for cover as soon as you get in the air, because you're basically just going to want to find stuff to shoot at. And when you see targets getting marked, you'll see exactly kind of where you want to go. So I'm going to go up to this hill right here for cover. And essentially what you want to do is you want to pop up above the hill, take a shot, pop back under, get behind another hill. So that way you won't be predictable and people basically won't be able to shoot you. Now there is an enemy aircraft in the air, but as long as he doesn't notice me, I should be fine. Alright, so I went a little further than I should have. And I'm about 2 kilometers away from the map. Now I'm going to ask my team to mark targets. This doesn't work all the time, but it's good. It's good so that you can actually get an idea of where your targets are. You'll get a little red chevron. I'm pretty sure if you already have a helicopter, you know what a target marker looks like. So what you're going to want to do is just rise above it slightly. Now I can see I have a target marked right there and a target marked right here. I'm going to turn my hover to about 0 or as close to 1 as I can. Negative 3 is fine. And I'm just going to look around for marked targets and see that there's a marked target right there. And I can take a shot. Okay, I think it actually just died right there, so I'm going to look around again. Now, I just remembered this. This blinking box right here, I'm just going to outline it in my editor. That you have to have your crosshair in that blinking box to actually take a shot. And if you want to change that, all you have to do is get out of hover mode, and then you can get right back into hover mode. And you can move that box. Alright, I was able to partially hit a striker, I think that is. No, it's not a striker. The turret looks really weird. But I can hit right about there. Now, without thermals, like I said before, this can be pretty difficult, because you won't be able to see the target yourself. You're going to have to rely on enemy markers or it just moving out in the open. But usually you'll be able to get at least one kill. Now, if you only have one ATGM left, you might want to go back, but you can just wait to launch it off. That's going to be about it. Thank you guys for watching. And if you did like this video, remember to hit subscribe and hit that like button so you get more videos just like this every week. And I will be uploading a close air support tutorial for fixed wing aircraft such as jets in the future, so remember to check that out. Anyway, thanks for watching.